Hi, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to present our application of OpenCL to numerical simulation in physics, namely, to solution of the so-called quantum Boltzmann equation. My name is Petr. I represent Moscow Engineering Physics Institute, Department of Solid-State Physics and Nanosystems, and Institute of Laser and Plasma Technologies, LAPLAS. Nice to meet you at IWOCL SYCLcon 2020. This is the outline of my talk. First, I give short introduction to the simulation of fast processes in physics and write our equation. Then I take a specific problem and modify the equation for better performance. Then I describe the OpenCL solver. And finally, I show its performance benchmark and discuss the results. The topic of this work is the numerical simulation of fast processes in solids. Fast processes are important in many physical problems. There are, for example, photon-induced electrons in holes in semiconductors, behaviour of optical field in laser physics, quantum state of superconductor and Bose-Einstein condensation. In my research group, we study solid state, and it is definitely quantum system, which is usually not easy to simulate correctly. Standard approach to simulate fast processes in quantum systems is kinetic equations. And here we show some example from our earlier works. Essentially, it is the system of nonlinear differential equations describing the occupations of quantum states in our problem and their dependence on time. For example, it can be electrons and holes in semiconductor generated by photo excitation. Our research group uses kinetic equations to study relaxation processes, and here we show two typical pictures from our studies. Well, but sometimes kinetic equations are not enough, as they neglect high-order correlations. For example, in simple kinetic equations, the average of product of two or more variables, the so-called correlator, is replaced by the product of their averages, but naturally it is usually not exact. And these higher order correlators can be essential for some more complicated physical problems. So, we need to go deeper. And this is the equation from the title of our work, Quantum Boltzmann Equation, in short QBE. It is the universal approach of the theoretical physics. I will not explain it in details. More information is given on the slide. The most important fact about QBE that it generates the system of differential equations for not only occupations of quantum states, like in kinetic equations, but also higher order correlators. Let's see the system which we solve in our work. So, in this work we simulate the so-called weakly interacting Bose gas. Here we see the quantum Boltzmann equation formulated for this problem. N is the occupation, while A is the two-particle correlator. Right part of the equations is again dependent on N and A, so this is a closed system of equations depending only on its variables and coefficients of the interaction model. Here we see formulas for the terms F1, F2, F3. I will not pay a lot of attention to them, and they will be shown later one more time. What we should say, however, there are too many variables and too many equations. They can be solved only numerically. So this is the main obstacle hindering the application of quantum Boltzmann equation, huge amount of variables and calculations. At this slide I give the estimations. For typical not very large system on the grid of size 8x8x8, we have two large arrays of 2 GB and very large count of calculations required to calculate the right part of equations. This is not what we can calculate even in several seconds. And for the grid size of 10x10x10, the numbers are even less realistic. Moreover, this amount is needed for each single step of calculations, but usually we need thousands of steps, probably tens of thousands, and even more. So, such simulation would be extremely slow and practically impossible. And in this work, we are trying to make it possible. Actually, we did it. All details are given in the proceedings, and here I describe main steps and the results. Let's see what we can do. First, we analyze the workflow. Actually, smaller systems are not bad. For example, if large system is impossible to simulate, and even if it's possible, but takes too long time, we can simulate smaller systems and then extrapolate the result to a larger size. So probably two large systems are simply not needed. But still, to accelerate the simulation of smaller systems would be nice. What we can do next? Main steps to achieve decent performance. Before developing the simulation program and using OpenCL, we analyzed the equations to find some transformation, essentially decreasing the amount of calculations. The details are discussed in the proceedings. And next step, now we are ready to develop the program. We apply OpenCL to perform our calculations on the graphical accelerator. Usually our problems greatly benefit from moving to GPUs. Typical speedup is about 30 times. I specifically talk about solid-state problems studied in my research group. GPUs have higher memory bandwidths, fast local memory, some of them have more teraflops than CPU, etc. Let us note, here we calculate the same formulas again and again, and we call the same batch of kernels many times. So I used the production CL library for iterative scientific calculations, which I presented at IWOCL 2017. What about useful OpenCL optimizations? Well, they are typical. Reasonable grid dimensions, reduction in local memory, and large memory arrays have staged offsets to avoid bank conflicts. Next steps are testing of our simulation program and benchmarks. Testing. Here we show the time behavior of some example system, two-dimensional, lattice size 4x4. Other parameters are not very important. The graphs are N, occupation of quantum states, and the real part of A, two-particle correlator. We see that the graphs show some oscillations. We can say that the program is stable. This is similar calculations for larger system, 6x6. Again, these two pictures show that the program is stable. And that's it. And finally, benchmarks. Let's see how good is our OpenCL solver. In our benchmarks, we measure the time needed to calculate the right part of the equations. The lower is better, and usable times should be lower than approximately 1 second. We check several system sizes at several GPU accelerators and also check the performance of our OpenCL code running on the CPU. And for comparison, we also run this serial single-threaded Fortran version. What we can expect? First, we'd like to know the speedup achieved over CPU. How much? 20 times? 100 times? We will see. Second, the formulas are rather simple, so the effect of GPU architectures and generations should not be very significant. And moreover, the problem is memory bound, so maybe even the single-threaded CPU program can use all the memory bandwidths. And number three, we will see the effects of runtime overheads and optimizations for different accelerators and drivers. Here I show the details of test systems and accelerators. Two NVIDIA accelerators, two AMD accelerators, two CPUs, Intel and AMD, two operating systems, Windows 7 and Debian Linux, several runtimes. And I show the compiler keys for serial Fortran version. So this is the benchmark results for two-dimensional system. System size which fits the memory can be up to 26. Actually, we also have 1.4 size 28. The graph points are the time in seconds to calculate one step, time in logarithmic scale, lower is better. Actually, we see several similar graphs going mostly in parallel. Main facts from this plot. First, graphical accelerators show decent speedup over CPU, approximately 30 times, as we expected. Second, times for all our GPUs are mostly the same, which proves the fact that in this problem only memory bandwidth is important. And single-threaded Fortran version is not very slow. And third, all system sizes which fit the memory are okay. The calculation time does not exceed 1 second, so they can be simulated in our research. Now let's see the benchmark for three-dimensional problems. Similar graph for three-dimensional problems. Now the system size can be only 4, 6 or 8 to fit the accelerator memory. Main facts are the same. The speedup is approximately 30 times over CPU. All system sizes from 4 to 8 allow calculation in less than 1 second, so they can be used in practical research. Various CPU versions show different performance, and some of them even allow to take larger system size, but it will be slow and impractical. So, our results. We developed the OpenCL solver for quantum Boltzmann equation applied to our specific solid-state problem. The solid performance allows us to simulate large enough systems with sub-second time for a single calculation step, which is good enough for practical study. Our optimizations include not only OpenCL-specific tricks, but also modification of the initial mathematical problem. This solver will be used in our research to study fast processes in various non-equilibrium quantum systems. Thanks for your attention. This is my email. Please ask your questions. And also I would like to invite students to my university and my department of solid-state physics and nanosystems. You can find details at these websites. Thanks again.